And then I saw that one Saturn was in the fourth house. From there, what he's doing?
Aspecting.
He's aspecting the 10th house secondary, but primarily he's aspecting the Lagna first. Interesting. If you want to know the power of this, na, you just check Lord Ram's horoscope. Mm-hmm. Now, there are some controversies about Lord Ram's horoscope. I will not go into that. There's a debate on the position of Sun. Some say Sun is in the 9th house in Pisces. Some say it's in Aries, mm-hmm. in the 10th house with Mercury. I will exclude Sun. Forget Sun. Let's talk of Lord Ram's chart. Because in any tradition in India, that's the first chart we learn. And unfortunately, we are doing it last, but we must do it. So Lord Ram is a Cancer ascendant. Mm-hmm. And he has Jupiter and Moon in the ascendant. Jupiter is exalted. Mm-hmm. And Moon is in fourth charan of Punarvasu Nakshatra. Mm-hmm. Now, let's kick off with the rules. Ascendant. That means now he will see every house with the eyes of these two planets.
True, yeah.
And interestingly, for Cancer, Jupiter is which lord? It is the lord of 6th and the 9th.
9th, yeah.
So when the trinal lord is sitting in the ascendant, it's very prominent placement. Mm-hmm. So that means the 9th lord is sitting in Lagna. So whichever house he looks, he will look with the lens of the 9th lord.
Right, yeah.
And what is 9th house? 9th house is the house of Dharma. And Jupiter gets exalted there in Cancer. So exaltation means what? Exaltation is good, debilitation is bad. That is what they will tell you, right? Oh my God, my Venus is debilitated. My relationships are ruined forever. Exaltation means awareness is very high. Debilitation means the awareness is very low. Mm-hmm. The moment, how to know which planet is exalted in somebody's chart without knowing their chart? You give them 9 topics related to the 9 planets. Mm-hmm. You tell them that if I ask you to speak on any of these 9 topics, mm-hmm. which one will you choose? Okay. Just tell them, oh, this Jupiter represents this, Venus represents this. Suppose somebody has an exalted Venus. That person will jump, oh, I will speak on relationships.
Okay.
Because he is very aware of relationships, either the absence or the presence of relationships. Mind it. Mm. Anything which happens in the area of relationships will affect him millions of times more. Because his Venus is in a state of exaltation. It means it's like bubbling with enthusiasm. That planet is telling, look at me, look at me, look at me, feel me. And now imagine that planet is afflicted. Saturn is afflicting exalted Venus. My God. 24 hours you will be thinking of why I don't have relationships. Now suppose Saturn is afflicting Venus. And Venus is an ordinary dignity, some not so great sign for Venus. Mm-hmm. Then you are like, okay, anyways, there are no relationships, forget it. But suppose it is exalted. Oh my God, I am totally aware of the fact that I am not happy in marriage. So then your life becomes difficult. Then you can say my Venus is ruined. Because you are feeling it 24 hours. So now in case of Lord Ram, his 9th Lord, which is Jupiter, it is exalted. And it is in the ascendant. So his lens is that see everybody through the highest level of Dharma. And ninth house is also rules and law books and all this, right?
Yeah.
That is why he's known as Maryada Purushottam.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect follower of principles. Otherwise, how will you get that? You won't get.
True.
And then moon is also sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
Moon is what basically? Moon in one word is the society. You will think, oh, moon is my mind, blah, 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 all such stuff. Nah. What mind? Mind is this, that. Moon is that. The placement of moon will tell you how the society affects you. Always. Anybody who has moon in Leo, just check them, depending on their whole chart.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow or the other, they are always talking, discussing about people, with people about politics. Why? Because the moment they hear about election or prime minister or president, their blood boils. They cannot resist from being a part of that discussion. They cannot resist.
Hmm.
So now, in that, in case of Lord Ram, his Jupiter and Moon are in the ascendant. So Moon is telling, and Moon is an own sign, very strong. It's in Cancer. And it is with an exalted planet and a great friend.
Mm-hmm.
And Jupiter, what he does, whichever planet he sits or aspects, he expands. Yes?
Yeah.
So now Lord Ram, he sees every house with the lens of an exalted Jupiter and Moon, which is also kind of bloated. So, my mother, stepmother said to my father, hey, just get out of here for 14 years. Okay, if that is what makes you happy, I will do it. No problem. Oh, you want me to go out? Fine, no problem. Moon has the tendency to please other people. So he's always like, oh, how can I please you? So just for the sake of his mother, stepmother,
mm-hmm.
he made that entire sacrifice. And that's very interesting. He was supposed to be coronated as the king the next day. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
And you are going to be sitting in the throne of Ayodhya. It is said in the Ramayana that Ayodhya was more prosperous than Amaravati. Amaravati is the city where Indra resides.
Mm-hmm.
It was more prosperous than the king of the heavens, the city.
Wow.
And you are going to sit in the throne, and what do you have? You have a wife like Sita. He has an exalted Venus, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Seventh Lord Saturn is also exalted. Perfect wife.
Mm-hmm.
You have brothers like Lakshman, you have brothers like Bharat and Shatrughna. Before anything comes near you, they will finish it off. I mean, what do you want, man, in life? But there's that one planet sitting in the fourth house. Do you notice Saturn?
Yeah.
That Saturn is throwing the aspect to the Lagna. And it is ruining the entire life of Lord Ram. Because that is an exalted Saturn, you see. Very aware.
Yeah.
So the Lagna is afflicted by Saturn. So when the Lagna is afflicted by Saturn, it's like saying your very existence is denied. And what did Kaikai say? Not only can't you be the king, you also have to get out of the kingdom for 14 years. My God.
Mm-hmm.
Which means you cannot eat food, yes, of the king. And when you go outside, you stay in forest, you are supposed to follow celibacy, which means you are not enjoying with your wife also. Which means it's like you are dead. Almost. For a materialistic person, to be married and not to enjoy with his wife, and who are supposed to be the king the next day, and he goes to forest for 14 years, he will die. But his ascendant is very strong. The lord of the ascendant is sitting in the ascendant with an exalted planet. So the ascendant is like, I will handle it. that feeling which is there, I will handle it. That's very, very, very strong. So the aspect of Saturn could not do anything. People will say, oh, what to do? My Saturn is aspecting my ascendant, right? My whole life is ruined. Saturn can only ruin a weak ascendant. He cannot ruin a strong ascendant.
True.
It will have its effects, no doubt. Saturn will show his colors. But will he be able to overpower you or not? That will depend on the ascendant. Because wherever there is light, there cannot be darkness. Light and darkness cannot coexist. Sun is the light, Saturn is darkness.
Darkness, yeah.
So wherever there is darkness means what? Your existence is denied, right? So that's what and of course, in his case, Saturn is the lord of the seventh house. So the day he got married, it got activated. He was not married, everything is fine. Keke is like, oh, in fact, the Ramayana says Keke loved Ram more than she loved Bharat. But Saturn got activated. And Saturn is who actually? Saturn is the servant, Manthara. And now here's the interesting thing. What's the fourth house in anybody's chart? Fourth house is the house of the mother, right?
Yeah.
So that means in his life, once his mother or fourth house also shows personalities who are like mother to you, your stepmother or anybody like that who takes care of you. They will be under influence of Saturn. And who is Saturn? Saturn is the servant, right?
Oh, makes sense, yeah.
That is like the ascendant of the mother. There are rishis like Vasishta who is sitting there. And Keke doesn't listen to him. Dasharath Maharaj is falling at his feet. He's saying, I'm begging you. You want me? I will go to Indra and fight with him and I will put you in the throne of the heavens. But please don't ask that. Banish Ram to forest. I cannot live without Ram. I will die. She's going to become a widow, but she's least concerned. She's only concerned with what Manthara is telling. Who is Manthara? Manthara is sitting in her
head.
So that will affect her always. And because Saturn is retrograde, it's not mother, it's stepmother. Beautiful chart it is. Without that chart, you cannot understand what ascendant is. Everything is useless. So that's the beauty of his chart, that we saw his ascendant and his mother's ascendant also. And the seventh house is like the kind of the ascendant of your spouse, right? So the moment he got married, what happened? Mars is sitting there. So he'll start fighting. And in fact, because it is an exalted Mars, because Mars is exalted in Capricorn, he started fighting before only. He killed Tarka, Subahu, Marich. Marich was not killed, of course. It's a very interesting chart.
Yeah.
Of course, we can go on and on discussing on Lord Ram's chart. It's like never ending, but that's how you see. In his case, although the aspect of Saturn is there, which played out its role, but it could not overpower the ascendant.
True.
Because he was fixed with his ideals. Ninth Lord in Lagna, whatever God has given me, I will accept.
I love that placement. That's amazing.
Huh?
Ninth Lord in Lagna, like that is one of the best placements to have.
Yeah. Lagna Lord in ninth. Always, whenever there is any problem, go to the Guru and ask, what should I do? Read the scriptures, find out where the problem is. So that's what the ascendant is. We need to check Mars, we need to check Sun, we need to check Jupiter, and also the functional ruler of the ascendant. Functional ruler means whoever is the lord of the ascendant. So suppose somebody is having Venus as the lord of the ascendant, and Venus is exalted, suppose. So then they will be completely be, so that's like saying the person wants to see the world through the eyes of Venus, the sign in the ascendant, and Venus is exalted. So it's like saying the person is completely aware that I should be me. And suppose Venus is in debility. It's like saying I don't like me. It's a serious problem. And I know one of my friend, he's a Taurus Lagna. His Venus is in fifth house in the sign of Virgo.
Oh.
And what he will say, oh, Lagna Lord in fifth is a great placement, which it is indeed. And he will say, oh yeah, you know, Venus is here. Venus in the fifth is a great placement. Venus in the fifth may be great, but as the Lagna Lord in Virgo in debility, that's a difficult placement.
Challenging, yeah.
Now, Venus in fifth can have its own advantages. Like you are always surrounded by ladies. And which he is all the time. But his only complaint is my relationships don't work. So now the ascendant lord is Venus. So for him, and this is also another clue. What is your, whichever is the lord of the ascendant, that sign which is there in the ascendant. Every house, you will have a flavor to watch it through that house. Because that's what the planet is basically, the Lord of the Ascendant. So suppose somebody is, you know, a Capricorn or an Aquarius. Ascendant, Capricorn, Ascendant, Aquarius, Ascendant. You will always see that whichever area of life it is, they are kind of grounded to some extent. Why? Because Saturn is the Lord of the Ascendant. And on the other hand, you will see a Leo Ascendance. It's very distinctly visible that somebody is a Leo Lagna. Why? You can distinctly identify.
Yeah. Because of Sun.
Yeah. So that means the ascendant defines the definition of success in life. Their definition of success is, I should be like the sun. I mean, you are already pretending to be like the sun, because we saw that sun is our one of those three planets, right? And now it is also ruling your ascendant. So that's like 10 times more. Then you will see people who are ruled by Mars. They're always focused on body and keeping the body fit. Why? Because their definition of success is Mars.
True.
The body. And Sag and Pisces Lagna people you will see. Always they will be like, okay, focus on God, do this, do that. Why? Because their definition of success, depending on the whole chart, of course, these statements cannot be studied independently from the chart. So nobody should feel that, oh, I am a Scorpio Lagna, I am not like this. So if somebody is a Sagittarius or a Pisces, you will see they have a natural inclination, may not be for God or for Shiva or for Ram or Jesus or Krishna, but these people will have a kind of, will have a conception somewhere inside that maybe there is something greater in life, you know. Because Jupiter is the Akash Tattva, which is beyond all this. So they will have this conception. Maybe there is something beyond. I may not know what it is, but there is something. And because Jupiter is the Lagna Lord, so that's the definition of success. So this is how, you know, you study the ascendant. So next time when you get charts for matching horoscopes, before jumping into that house, just give a look at the seven, at the ascendant. Before jumping at the 10th house, look at the ascendant. A person who has Mercury in the ascendant will always be calculative, regardless of any house it is.
Wow.
That is why sometimes they have difficulties in marriage, people with Mercury in the Lagna. Because in the sign of Mercury, Venus gets debilitated.
True.
People with Jupiter in the ascendant, you will see that they're not very keen on fighting. They are that, you know, peacemakers. Why? Because the sign where Jupiter gets exalted, Cancer, Mars gets debilitated there. So then you can infer another rule from the ascendant.
Yeah.
You can make 20 rules for judging the ascendant like this. You can keep going on making rules like this. And suppose there is no planet which is there in the ascendant. Many times people don't have planets in the ascendant. So then you see who is the lord of the ascendant or which planets are aspecting the ascendant. Sometimes you don't have any planets which are aspecting also. That means that nothing affects you very strongly. Because ascendant questions your existence, right? Because suppose somebody has Venus in ascendant, there's a problem in relationships. He will think my entire existence is under threat. Because the ascendant is like the king. So it's like you are telling, I'll pull down the king. I will not let you sit there. The ascendant is like the sun. So when you say I'm denying the sun, it's like, it's very painful. Mercury in the ascendant, anything to do with finances will wreak havoc in your life. Marriage maybe, may not be. Finances definitely, anything to do with information, knowledge, stuff, all these things, that is going to take a toll on your entire horoscope. And that is why you will see the 10th house sometimes gives weird answers, but the person is doing something else.
Yeah.
Oh, you will see, the 10th house has planets like those. Like there was one chart I saw. 10th house had Mars and Rahu. So what you will say now? Maybe the person is, you know, fighting or, you know, this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Yes. But the person is into teaching. Why? Because Jupiter is in the ascendant.
Okay, nice.
So that person's definition of success is what? It is Jupiter. Teach. Jupiter means I should behave like a guru or I should give knowledge, give wisdom. Mm-hmm. And now that does not mean that the 10th house will not have its effects. For him, the 10th house has Mars and Rahu. So now that means anything, when it comes specific to career, there's another lens now, you see. There are three lenses now. Like in cameras, you have multiple lenses, right?
Yeah.
Ascendant is the lens which is just the first lens. Then other lenses are like this.
True.
So when first the light is coming, it will hit and then the ascendant will decide what I will let, what is the thing that I will allow in my kingdom. If the ascendant is not allowing, it will not happen.
True.
That is why Jupiter in Lagna people or Sagittarius or Pisces Lagna people, if Jupiter is in a reasonable dignity, mm-hmm. you will see they will not be too much interested in finding faults or looking down on people. Why? Because their definition of success is, oh, only look good in people. Mm. Moon in the ascendant, people you will see. Mm. Always anything happens, they will start crying. Why? Because they have made a rule for themselves. That anything happens to them, it happens to me. Because moon has this tendency to feel inside very much.
Empathy for the people.
Career problem, they will cry. Relationship problem, they will cry. Child problem, they will cry. All the time they are crying sometimes. Mm. Or Cancer Lagna also you will find. Mm. Because that's their definition of success. Moon is telling, this is my kingdom. I will only allow emotions here. Mm. Nobody else will be allowed. And somebody has Saturn in Lagna. Wow. I have a friend, you know, Saturn in Lagna. Mm-hmm.